Hey everybody, I'm Pam from the Nonfiction Department at the Hoover Library, and today I am sharing the books discussed at the October Insatiable Readers session. Insatiable Readers meets one Saturday morning each month to talk about nonfiction books. If you are interested in hearing more book suggestions and would like to attend a virtual Insatiable Readers session, please email me at the address included in the description below. Now, on to our books for today. These books were presented at the October 2020 session, Short Nonfiction. All of the books that we talk about today are available in both physical and ebook format to check out from our library. The first book that we have today is About Us, Essays from the Disability Series of the New York Times. This book was published in 2019. Since its 2016 debut, the New York Times Disability Column has transformed the national dialogue around disability. This collection gathers the most powerful essays from that series. They reflect on the difficult conversations around disability, and the essays included here reveal the range of responses and the variety of consequences to being labeled disabled by the broader public. Black is the Body by Emily Bernard was published in 2019. In these 12 connected essays, Bernard details the experience of growing up Black in the South, surviving a random stabbing at a coffee shop, marrying a white man from the North and adopting two children, and living and teaching in a primarily white New England college town. Each of the essays set out to discover a new way to talk about race. This is one of the most beautifully written books that I have read in a while, and I highly recommend it. Our next book is actually a series. The Best American Essay Series is a yearly anthology of magazine articles that have been published in the United States. The series began in 1986, and the series editor, Robert Atwin, chooses article candidates from which a different guest editor each year picks about 25 or so for publication. The latest edition in 2019 featured guest editor Rebecca Solnit, and the 2020 version will be released next month in November. A Briefer History of Time by Stephen Hawking was published in 2005. After receiving repeated requests for a more accessible version of A Brief History of Time, Hawking responded with this volume. Although briefer, this book both clarifies and expands on the subjects covered in the original, and it also records the latest developments in the field of physics. The Pleasures of Reading in an Age of Distraction by Alan Jacobs was published in 2011. In recent years, cultural commentators have sounded the alarm about the dire state of reading in America. Americans are not reading enough. They're not reading the right things. But in this slim book, Jacobs argues that contrary to this opinion, reading is very much alive and well in America. He also offers some advice for readers, which I am quite fond of, and that is read at whim, read what gives you delight, and do so without shame. My Life as a Villainess by Laura Lippman was published in 2020. In this collection of new and previously published essays, best-selling author Lippman offers her take on a woman's life across the decades. She explores motherhood as an older mom, her life as a reader, and her relationships. Vesper Flights by Helen MacDonald is our next book. It was published in 2020, and it is a collection of MacDonald's best love essays combined with new pieces on topics ranging from nostalgia for a vanishing countryside to the tribulations of farming ostriches to her own private vespers while trying to fall asleep at night. The Origin of Others by Toni Morrison, published in 2017, is based on her 2016 Charles Eliot Norton lectures that she gave at Harvard University. Morrison considers history, politics, literature, and her own memories in this search for answers as to why humans construct an other and why this other makes us so afraid. Our next book is Late Migrations by Margaret Wrinkle, and it was published in 2019. Growing up in Alabama, Wrinkle was a devoted reader, an explorer of nature, and a fiercely loved daughter. In these brief essays, she presents a portrait of her complicated parents, observations on the world surrounding her suburban home, and thoughts on the beauty that is to be found in our ordinary, everyday lives. Letters to a Young Poet by Rainier Maria Rilke was published in 1929. This is a collection of 10 letters written by poet Rilke to a young aspiring poet, postulating on poetry and also on surviving as a sensitive observer in a very harsh world. The Collected Schizophrenias by Esme Wong was published in 2019. Winner of the Gray Wolf Press Nonfiction Prize and a Whiting Award, this book explores the questions of identity that the ill, particularly the mentally ill, must contend with. Night by Elie Wiesel is our final book for today. Published in 1956, this memoir by the Nobel laureate chronicles his experience with his father in the concentration camps during the height of the Holocaust. Thank you so much for watching today. I hope that you enjoyed this look at short nonfiction. I'll see you soon with some more Insatiable Readers book suggestions. Until then, take care of yourself and have a great day.